The national security chief in Israel recently stated that they're going to order 10,000 rifles for their civilian security teams. 10,000 rifles. They're going to need a lot more than that. They're going to order it from an Israeli manufacturer. And the whole thing just got me wondering, if they were in the situation that they're in, if they are in a situation where security is a big deal in their country, why wouldn't they have a culture where they allow law-abiding citizens to carry guns to protect themselves in case something like this did happen? Like, why wait until a crisis occurs to say, okay, we're going to give civilian guns? And so, like, what happened in Ukraine, where they were handing out rifle, well, there's stories about them handing out weapons to civilians. I mean, the thing is, you want to have a culture in place. You want to make sure people are already familiar with the guns. You want to make sure it's just a part of your civilization. So when something like this does happen, when there is a crisis, people are able to really respond to it. And now there's panic buying in Israel at the grocery stores. You know, it sort of reminds me of, you know, why people should prepare for emergencies in case there is a big event. And people said, oh, well, nothing's happened. Preppers been talking about this for years. Well, there's Hurricane Katrina. There's a lot of different examples of things going wrong. And it makes sense to put yourself in a position where you have options. That's all emergency preparation really is. Emergency preparedness. That's what it's about. Food, water, shelter, basic stuff. Having a plan. But anyway, that's what's going on in Israel right now. There's other countries around Israel talking about how they might get involved if the United States gets involved. The United States is sending an aircraft carrier group over. I think they're going to get involved. There's a humanitarian situation. There are some serious questions about Gaza before this whole attack. The living conditions there. Again, I'm not justifying what I'm seeing as far as all these Israelis being killed, women and children. And people always say women and children, but it doesn't mean that the men deserve to die. I mean, they're innocent people. The men, we have value. Well, we have value too. Our lives matter too. So, but anyway, I get it. There's one site, I'm not going to talk about it too much, where they found multiple bodies. Children, I'm not going to even get into all that. Some really extreme stories out there. There's also a lot of BS stories out there as well. So you got to be careful about that. But yeah, so the humanitarian issue is going to be a big issue, because now how are they going to get food and water into the Gaza? Because the Israeli government has said that, hey, we're going to shut off the food, the water, electricity. Definitely there's talk about water being limited. So what's going to happen if they're really going to shut off the water? What's going to happen with those the civilians in Palestine, in the Gaza area, Gaza Strip? What's going to happen with them? You know, so I think the King of Jordan offered to send some humanitarian aid. Question is, will Israel allow that to go through? The problem Israel has to deal with is, okay, so how do you provide food and water and basic necessity to the people of Gaza without aiding your enemy, Hamas? Because Hamas, they don't represent everybody in the Gaza Strip, okay? It's an organization. They're being called terrorists by Israel, and it certainly if you're harming innocent people, that makes sense. I mean, it makes sense to get that label. You cannot justify some of the stuff I've seen online. But you also can't have a situation where we have Palestinians not having access to food and water. And so right now the Israelis are talking about adding another 60,000 troops in their reserves. They already called up 300,000. Now they're going to add another 60,000, and they're getting ready for their ground war. It looks like there's going to be a ground war. They're hitting Lebanon with airstrikes right now. So it looks like Lebanon is going to end up getting involved. Hezbollah, if they start firing missiles, and I see the United States using that aircraft carrier to hit them in certain areas as well. I think once they get involved, then Iran could possibly get involved. So I think about the whole situation. As a lot of you guys responded to my last video by saying that you don't think everybody within the Israeli government was ignorant of the situation. My point was that you can still have a situation where the intelligence was gathered, the analysts highlighted the important intelligence, and it was even may have even been presented to the right people, but those people may have not responded. I think it may be a political problem within the political class. I could be wrong. A lot of guys drew comparisons to 9/11, and I totally get that. Maybe the situation is being used by certain people, but I have no evidence that this is a operation, that type of operation. I don't have any evidence of that. I don't like to accuse people of things if I don't have any evidence. What we do know is that there was a major attack. Over 900 Israelis, or 700 or so Israelis, were killed. Now there's people in Gaza, Palestinians, being killed as well. I'm sure a lot of them were involved in the Hamas operations, but obviously if you're dropping bombs in highly densely populated areas, you're going to have civilians being killed as well. So I think the United States is going to get involved. I think this war is going to spread and get wider. I think there's going to be a huge humanitarian cost for the people in Gaza. It's going to be probably a two-front war for Israel. Then they're going to have to worry about Iran, and the United States is going to get involved in dealing with Iran. And I'm sure there's a bunch of neocons in DC who love the idea of us finally going to war with Iran, because this is the war they wanted. Hope you guys are preparing, because the situation is not looking good. So share your thoughts.